Welcome back, everyone. We're just gonna do a quick video. I know it's been a while since I last recorded this game, but right now all we're gonna do is just finish up the basically the road connecting Mountain Knot City all the way to, you know, connecting to Lake Knot City, south, all the way to South Knot City. So I believe I only have this one left, and let's just keep this at, and let's just finish this and see how it goes.
So much better.
And also gonna show on this one, we're just gonna show how to get Hyrule. I guess I say the easiest way or the fastest way. This one takes a long time to do. I think I tried to play this for like at least a good week, and I would say I appreciate whoever else is playing, because I didn't do this alone. Other players, I don't really know how the network works on PS4. I know for the fact that people can help build the roads. You know, they can also like add materials to it if it wasn't enough, but I believe I managed to do at least, I would say 60%. I don't know how it looks like on somebody else's account, but so far we only have one more paver left. We'll see how it goes, and obviously, and also that one is close to the mule's territory. Oh, that's right. So right now I don't have enough chiral. So I'm gonna do right now is I would obtain chiral pretty fast. Let me just park this here. If you have a vehicle and you try to basically park that close to when you have to fight a BT, it for some reason it unload everything, so it's kind of just pain in the ass to put it back. Right now it's pretty clear. Oh, I assume there's nothing here. Ah.
Let's go.
Hey!
Let's not get too far. There's supposed to be one over here, but unless building that road. So currently right now I have a level 3 power skeleton. This one's really good, gonna let you handle more weight. The gloves I would say is good too, and the chiral boots are probably the best one to have. And if you need that one, you can get it at, usually at Cairo Artist Studio. So if you just need one, or you wanna keep, a pair or something, just get a mission that will let you deliver the package there. It's not raining now. And you know what? We're just gonna deliver all this material first and I'll get the Cairo after. Special alloys, I don't know about that. So we're gonna try to gate sensors. Yes, managed to do it. And I managed to get stuff. So this one takes quite a bit of material. It is very random, but some of these auto pavers takes a lot of material for some reason, and some don't, even though it doesn't, it's not that long. And I am short still. So I am short 470, I believe. So I'm gonna do with that is, let me fill this up. Oh, I managed to fill that up. Cool. So I'm gonna get is, I'm gonna take some material from one of the stations. What we gonna do? How long it took me to even, and then I didn't even do all of it. So let's claim material, ceramic. I believe I needed like 470, I said. That's not what I meant to do. So let's see. Oh, I guess I said that wrong. Scratch that. So I need 570. So what I'm gonna do is just grab 580. Just makes it so there is a actually. Let's make that. I believe I need 580, so there you go. So let's put this in the truck. Actually, yeah, I have a whole bunch of chemicals and stuff over here. You know what? So I'm gonna do it right now. I'm just gonna take the... I'm just gonna get a motorcycle now. So... hopefully I have enough. That's a defensive one. I don't really don't need that one. Okay. So abandoned one. Hopefully it didn't abandon this one. We're gonna use this one, just you can already tell how fast it is. But obviously you need to keep your battery. You have to stay in the middle. Which is usually pretty hard on the corner. There's a pretty good amount of station here anyway, so you can charge the battery. Almost lost it there. Max speed now, all the way. So right now, all they're saying is I'm too far on all the materials I left. Just gonna let another porter do it. Let me build this thing real quick. So this should be the last one. Oh, it goes higher. I was wondering what it was gonna do since it was in the Mio territory. So let's get into my bike. This one. Alright, so you guys can already tell I came from Mountain Knot City. We're gonna go through Lake Knot City and to the South Knot City. Just show you guys that what a full built road looks like. So if you have to like transport something in one of those facilities, it just makes it so much easier because you can grab one of those trucks. The one I was using is about level 3. So So that one takes a lot more. And you really don't have to like fight someone. Right now we're going, we are at... I usually don't tell you what this means. Oh, there you go. So this is the center, north, on that city. Going back out again. Just bear with me here. It usually doesn't take long, but... trust me, this is way faster than the truck. So, like I said, like if you ever happen to like be in the mule territory, you can, all you have to just time it. You can negate the raider. So obviously, I forgot what level or chapter of the story where you can basically update or upgrade your scanner. So you can even do a wheelie. It's supposed to make it faster, but it doesn't. Once you're max, you're max. I wish they make the angle for the bikes. I think this angle should be really, really good. So right now we're at the west of Lake Knot City, which is right about here. So all of that, we came from here. Oh, that's a time fall, sorry. Right here. From Monat City, we just followed through that road and we're at the West Lake Knot City. And now we're gonna go to Lake Knot City first, then just head back and follow the other road. Charge my bike real quick. There you go. Right now, I usually just take that turn, but it's just go over straight, just to make it easier. Same way. Roadside factory. On that factory, if you need ceramic, I think the max one they probably give you is about maybe 800 or 900 on there. And also, see how we just passed by it. If I didn't have the road there, you could still pass it without really have to engage a VT. You just have to go as close as to that water and you'll be fine. But some areas you just can't. You just have to go follow. So right now we're heading to, you see, we just passed that Y intersection, so if you make a left, it's towards Lake Knot City. So if you guys like this video, just, you know, press the like button. If you guys have any comment or if you guys got any suggestions or we can make this video better, let me know in the comment down below. So I'm gonna try to make this video really short and instead of just playing, like, you know, making a video for an hour, but we're just gonna show you guys a road and basically ways to destroy a BT. So here we are. We're now at Lake Knot City. If you guys aren't aware, there's a little charging station here and you can walk. Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges. Instead of like parking your vehicle in a garage, you have to sleep. You can usually skip it, but the process still takes a little longer. So right now we're headed back to the Y intersection. Keep on keeping up. And instead of, I'll show you guys over there. They said someone just delivered something on an auto paver, but could have sworn I took care of everything. Let me double check that real quick. Sorry guys. Yeah, I did everything. That might just be on their end. Alright, so now we are at the Y intersection. So if you go make a right, that goes to Mountain Knot City. And right now we're just gonna go straight. Alright, now we are at South Knot City. actually something.
There you go.
Set her south.
We are still headed. Keep going straight. Just a little bit long. Damn. This one, if anybody gets finished it, you just have to be careful when you're on it. Because it is a pretty good drop. You're probably gonna end up dying on this. Long straightaways and head to Salt Lake City. There you go. Now we made it. So that's how it looks like if you built a road fully. It does make if you have a package that needs to deliver it on Mana City, I believe the north, or there should be another one right here on Waystation 1. It makes it really, really easy. So right now, we're gonna head back to the distribution center, and I'm gonna show you guys what I created. I don't know if you can reach that one. It might be too far.
Clear. Weapons.
I don't know, I think I should probably just create another video for defeating a BT. We'll see how far I am in my video. See, I'm not even really that far out. It's only been 30 minutes. So I'm gonna edit this out. Alright, so. Yeah, I probably should make another video for that. So right now I'm just gonna show you guys the zip line. If you guys can make your own or alright, so it's the same way. I think most of this
welcome.
Zip line, like some of them are built by someone else, as you can tell.
Weapons restrictions lifted.
Alright, so what we're gonna do is
we have been expecting you.
We're gonna go to Mountain Out City by zip line. Right about here.
there.
I believe if you upgrade the zipline, you can go more than 300 meters. But just for the sake of like just building it, it is limited of your cargo bandwidth. So how much you can make. Or I should say how many. You see how right now I just passed that VT right now. There's no problem. Right now we're heading to the weather station. And I have another one right up there. But you guys can see it's like $299. I didn't want to upgrade it. I figured it should be fine. So if you have to deliver something to materials or whatsoever to Mountain Knot City, and it's not too much package where you can just, you know, carry it with you, this is probably the fastest way to do it. But if you have to carry so much materials and to transport, I would say the road is a lot better. This also, I built that zip line close to the roboticists, so I can stop right here and come down there. This down here, if you walk, there's gonna be VTs around. And I believe this should be the last one. If this is not the last one, it should be the second to the last one. Yeah, it should be second to the last one. Probably to make it faster. And here we are, back in Mountain Knot City. So, right now I'm gonna show you guys the same way. It goes towards to Lake Knot City. I created the zip line to go to a film director, at least close to it. To a junk dealer, which is right here. Then you can just walk and get what you need. And as you can see, there's another zip line here. There should be another zip line somewhere around here. Right here. Then I should go all the way to Carol Artist Studio. Probably won't. I don't know if I should tell you guys, but I probably would anyway. I am trying to create one to go to South Knot City. Basically, just have to go around here. And then go through here. But that's, like I said, that's if you need to deliver something from Cairo Artist Studio to South Knot City. But usually, I usually don't finish the side ones, like this little small. I try to only do the main one, just makes it easier. Anyways, that is it. My next video, I'm just gonna show you guys our scanning bridges ID. How to defeat a VT. I mean, obviously, I already finished the game, so I'm gonna have all the weapon, I believe. But you can also just use grenade if you need to. So.
Beginning scan. Scanning bridges ID.
Other than that, that's about it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video.
All clear.